Hello friends, very good evening and welcome to the YouTube session of Clinical Scenarios. So I'm Dr. Pediatric Mukherjee, your mentor in pediatrics, and I'm an educator in an academy as well. So this is my YouTube code. If you all are taking the plus subscription, then you can use my YouTube code that will help you avail 10% discount. Okay, now before I go ahead with today's two case discussion, which is going to be a very interesting discussion, because we are going to see, we always keep on doing the one-liners, we do the multiple choice questions, but clinical scenarios are something from, like, you have to pick up the diagnosis and then you need to answer the question, the options that they have given you. Okay, so I will be teaching you the trick as to how to solve these questions, and we have actually picked up a very interesting topic which is very commonly asked in pediatrics as well. Before that, let me tell you as to what is going on in an academy. So we are currently having this foundation batch course, NEET PG 2021, and this is the link for this. This course will be there till November. Okay, so if you have not yet joined, you can still join. It's ongoing and many interesting discussion is going to go on in this course. So it's the best course, you can join up currently. So this is my Telegram channel. Okay, and this is my Telegram group. So if you want to keep on getting the updates in pediatrics, you can definitely join my group. Plus, you can post your difficulties as well in the group, which I can attend shortly. Okay, now I want you all to do the two things. First is subscribe to this channel of Telegram channel of Unacademy. Second is click on the bell icon and the notification button. Okay, and subscribe to the channel. Okay, so I'll be flashing my YouTube code on every screen. Right, so once you have clicked on Unacademy, so you have to select NEET PG goal. Okay, and then you can come across the different live classes which are scheduled for the day and for the week. So you can just choose your subject and the educator from you whom you want to learn and go ahead with your learning. The payment system is very, very simple. So you just have to choose, like, you want it for how much months, how many months, like 1 month, 2 months, 6 months, 12 months. Okay, you can see the rates out here, it's given. Okay, and once you have decided whatever months, like suppose I want a 3 month subscription, I can just click on to that and it's 11.25k. So here I will go to the payment method. Okay, whichever bank, or if even if I want EMI options, it's there with me. Okay, so it's a very good and easy method. Now coming to what we are planning on YouTube this month, so we have these schedules on YouTube, so you can see all of them are quite interesting schedules. They are short sessions, but yet you see they are very informative, and they will definitely, you know, that is the best benefit of Unacademy platform. It is giving you many informative sessions that will definitely help not only the NEET aspirants but also those who are doing their MBBS or who are appearing for the FMG courses. Okay, now these are the free classes. These are 60 minute classes on the Unacademy. So again, you can see the topics, they are very interesting. So we have the revision basics, then we have the quiz sections, the previous year question discussion, the clinical questions, and the image based question. This is to give you an idea as to what we actually do on the Plus platform. So you're most welcome on to the platform of Unacademy. Right, so we started this course on 18 June, yet if you have not joined it, don't worry, whatever sessions has already been undertaken, they have been recorded. Okay, so you can see the recorded sessions and plus also get the PDF which will act as a notes for you. And as I told you, this session is till the month of November. So don't worry, there are 19 top educators who are actually giving you a complete training in 19 subjects, making it sure that you don't miss out on anything, because I totally agree that in this 6 months, covering up entire 19 subjects is a bit difficult, but all of us together can make it quite easy for you. Okay, so coming on to today's case discussion, so what I've done, I've picked up one diagnosis and I've picked up two different questions which were asked in your previous exam. And actually, this is a topic which is very frequently asked in pediatrics. Okay, so let's come to the question. So this is a 7-year-old boy who presented with generalized edema. So I totally agree that these long questions, they at times, they are quite time occupying. But don't worry, believe me, see, you can take up two ways. Either you read the last sentence and try to find out what is the answer, okay? But for me, okay, I prefer to read the entire question. Because I don't like to just go retrospectively and again keep reading it just to understand what is being asked. So when I attempt such questions, so generally I begin from the beginning, okay? But if you find that reading the last statement and then retrospectively quickly looking on to the points that they have mentioned will help you, both the methods are absolutely fine. Okay, so this is a 7-year-old boy who presented with generalized edema. Urine examination revealed albuminuria. Okay. Serum biochemical examination showed hyperalbuminemia with hyperlipidemia. And the kidney biopsy was undertaken on light microscopy. The kidney was novel and electron microscopy is likely to reveal. So they have given 4 electron microscopic findings. Now what they have given? They have given me 2 hints over here. 3 hints over here. Okay. So one is this edema. Second is albuminuria, third is hyperlipidemia. So these 3 are good enough to tell me that they are asking me about the nephrotic syndrome. Okay. Right. Now, we all know that the electron microscopy, so they have this typical finding of fusion of the food processes of the glomerular epithelium. Now, coming to the nephrotic syndrome, what is the most important factor which is asked? It is most common in pediatric age group. It is as much as 80% common. The second important point related to nephrotic syndrome is most common type of nephrotic syndrome is minimal change disease. Okay, now the next important question which is always asked about nephrotic syndrome are the steroid resistant nephrotic syndrome, right? So if you can just quickly tell me which are the different steroid resistant nephrotic syndromes. So first is the Finnish type, right? Second is focal segmental glomerulosclerosis. Okay, so there are 3 types of FSGS. We'll come to that later. The third is Denny's rash. So Finnish type, what is the gene associated with it? So this is a very commonly asked MCQ. So the gene is NPHS. One gene, okay, and the name is nephrin, right? Then now I told you FSGS is of 3 types. So what is it? So first is NPHS2, the name is podocin, okay. Then we have FSGS1 and FSGS2. Now this is alpha actinin 4. There is no name for this. Okay, coming to Denny's rash. So we have heard this name in Wilms tumor. So the gene associated with it is WT1 gene. Okay, so these are the common types, the common questions from the steroid resistant nephrotic syndrome, right? So our answer, well, we'll come to the answer. I'll tell you the answer is A, that is the fusion of the food processes of the glomerular epithelium. Okay. Now, coming to the pathological findings as to what we see in the So light microscopy is absolutely normal. So that was the question that was already told. Now coming to the electron microscopy, there is obliteration and fusion of the food processes of the epithelial cell that we saw. Then electron immunofluorescence will show no deposits, and the serum complements are absolutely normal. Okay, the serum complements are of normal level. So that was the question where it fitted. So this is a perfect answer that it is a case of a nephrotic syndrome, and the option given was amongst the option, the correct answer is A, right? So this is how it looks. So if you see a normal glomeruli, so you can see the placement, the glomerular capillaries, they have a separate food processes, so distinct separate food processes. Now here you can see a minimal change disease glomerular capillary has a fused food process. Okay, there's a fusion over here. You can very well compare the difference between this and this, right? So this is the real-time picture. You can make the difference. See here, all individual food processes you can make out, but here you cannot make out. It's all being fused. So this diagram you should be again able to recognize, because it can be asked for your MCQ as well. Okay, so coming to the drug of choice, so drug of choice is prednisolone. I've actually taken the entire treatment protocol of nephrotic syndrome, be it steroid frequent relapses, be it a frequent relapses or steroid dependent or steroid resistant cases. So you can come up in the Plus platform, and I've already given uploaded my lecture over there. So the entire nephrotic syndrome has been taken up very perfect manner, so that you are not missing out any point on nephrotic syndrome, and whatever question is being asked, you can definitely pick up the answer. Okay, now let's come to this next question. This is a 7-year-old girl who was brought with generalized swelling of the body, and there was a grade 3 proteinuria and the presence of fatty and hyaline cast. So remember that there won't be any hematuria in nephrotic syndrome, there won't be any RBC cast, but you can find hyaline and the fatty cast. Okay, so remember this, and there was no history of hematuria. So this was the second type of the same top question from the same topic. So which of the following statement about your condition is true? No IgG deposit or C3 deposition on renal biopsy. Her C3 level will be low. IgA nephropathy is a likely diagnosis, and Alport syndrome is a likely diagnosis. See here, this is a very clear cut case. Okay, so this the clue over here is first, that is edema, right? Proteinuria was my second clue. No hematuria. Okay, and the presence of hyaline and fatty cast. Okay, so these four clues were given to me. Now if you see the options over here, to me this is best nephrotic syndrome. Okay, this is completely suiting the nephrotic syndrome. Because first of all, see the age also. So nephrotics are very common between 6 to 8 years of age. That's the peak age of appearance. Okay, it can appear at any age between 1 to 10, but the peak is between 6 to 8. Now coming to the option number 1, so we saw that on examination when we do the biopsy, so there is no IgG deposits or no C3 deposition. Okay, so for me this is the answer. Now let's see the other options. Her C3 levels will be low. So in nephrotic syndrome, we have seen that the C3 levels are normal. So this cannot go with the option, with the question. IgA nephropathy. Again, no hematuria has been mentioned. So this goes against IgA nephropathy. Now Alport syndrome. So what do you understand by Alport syndrome? Yes. What are the three things that are suspected in Alport syndrome? So the first thing that we see in Alport syndrome is proteinuria, Second is sensory neural. Hearing loss, and third is ophthalmic or ocular defects. Okay, these mostly include mostly anterior lenticonus. Okay, then retinopathy. And cataract. Okay, so again Alport syndrome is out of question because they have not mentioned anything about sensory neural hearing loss or anything about of ocular manifestations. So again I won't go for this option. So my answer is quite clear that this is the thing. And secondly, if I can derive that what they are asking about, if I'm deriving the diagnosis, then my answers actually are focused. Okay, so I don't have any confusion between the answers. So I hope these two questions have helped you in understanding a bit of clinical based questions that can be asked for nephrotic syndrome. So that's all for today. I will again come up with some one more new set of MCQs of clinical based questions with a new topic, so that you will understand how to solve them and what are the tricks to pick up the correct answer. Thank you very much and stay safe. Stay healthy. Take care.